Hey folks, Arm & Hammer here with some last minute speculation about what we can expect from the CrossFit Games just a few days before it kicks off. We have an idea of how the CrossFit Games are gonna kick off for the individuals. Event 1 is gonna have a bike, Event 2 is gonna be 30 muscle-ups for time, Event 3 is the CrossFit total, and Event 4 is currently unannounced, but Dave Castro has hinted that it will round out the toughest, hardest, most challenging day one in CrossFit Games history. We also know that day one is on Wednesday, which leaves Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday for remaining days of competition. Now, we have seen a competition schedule similar to that previously, but we've also seen competition schedules where Thursday has been a rest day. My guess this year is that we are not going to be seeing a rest day on Thursday. The last time we saw the CrossFit Games run from Wednesday through Sunday with no days off was in 2016, when Thursday was a very light volume day involving just one event, a beach swim. While we don't know what the actual swimming event is going to be at the games, it's a fair assumption and my guess that we're gonna be seeing a swimming event on Thursday. I think we're gonna see a workout that has multiple rounds of swimming involved. Something like the 2013 pool event or the 2014 beach event, each of which had multiple rounds of swimming coupled with classic CrossFit movements. While Dave Castro doesn't pay attention to events that are not inside the CrossFit Games purview, I think that he may be taking some inspiration from Wadapalooza. A couple of years ago, Wadapalooza had a deadlift handstand pushup couplet, but there was a twist. The handstand pushups were on a barge in the middle of the bay, which means you would do your deadlifts on land, swim to the barge, and do your handstand pushups there before swimming back to complete one round of this multi-round workout. And I think that that is exactly what we're gonna be seeing at the CrossFit Games this year, based off of this Instagram post that I was tagged in by @B_Rooks. What we're looking at here is a barge in a lake in Madison. Having been at Wadapalooza and seeing the barge that they have there, and the fact that this is a Reebok branded, quote, fit barge, makes me feel like maybe this is gonna be involved. That said, CrossFit is very, very good at keeping their secrets close to their chest. So it's possible that this is some sort of inadvertent leak, but it's also possible that maybe this isn't the case. Either way, I know that I would love to see a cyclical swimming event show up at the games, and I think Thursday is the perfect day to see that. Earlier today, Dave Castro took to his Instagram story to show off the new stadium, and it looks awesome. At one end of it is this gigantic rig, tall enough for rope climbs, and he was kind enough to confirm that ropes will indeed be attached. Seeing the stadium and the rig at the end of it brings to mind two previous CrossFit Games events. The first is 2015's Stadium Chipper, involving pig flips, legless rope climbs, and a handstand walk race to the finish. This was an event that Ben Smith won and Matt Fraser fell apart on. The second is 2012's Rope Sled Workout, which is 5 rounds of a 20-foot rope climb followed by a 20-yard sled drive. Both of these events were incredibly fun to watch, and 2012's event is notoriously challenging. If these are the events that are inspiring Dave Castro when he's putting together the stadium events for the 2018 games, that is very good news because those events were great to watch and tested the athletes in a way that they did not know they could be tested. With the CrossFit Games just a few days away, we're going to be finding out more very soon. And you need someone to help you figure out what all of this means. That's what I'm here for. Catch you next time.